Hey everybody, the Hiking Chef here, and today I'm hiking to the top of Sierra Peak. Sierra Peak sits at about 3,057 feet elevation. It is located in the Santa Ana Mountains on the northernmost end of the Cleveland National Forest. This hike is about 15 miles long with 2,742 feet elevation gain. Remember, if you like this video, please hit the thumbs up button. And if you want to see more hiking and cooking outdoors, please subscribe to my channel. I got a lot of ground to cover and it's getting kind of cold out here, so let's go check it out. Update. I just made it to Picnic Rock. I'm about 5 miles in. So far it's been a beautiful, cold, brisk morning. Trail has been a little bit slick, muddy. We've had a lot of rain the past couple days. Pretty much just a big wide fire road. I got the Cleveland National Forest on this side, and then on the other side over here, I got the Three Sisters right there, Cucamonga, Ontario Baldy. Then we have Iron, Baden-Powell, Hawkins, Windy Gap, Mount Islip. We got Twin Peaks over there. We also have like Mount Lukens way over there. We have the Chino Hills National Park right in front of us. It's a beautiful view. And then way out here, you got the ocean, Catalina Island. I really like this hike so far. It's been pretty different for me lately because I've been doing the Angeles National Forest and, you know, the San Gabriel Mountains, Big Bear. So to be back in the Cleveland National Forest, it's a nice little change. Right behind me is Picnic Rock. Keep on heading up to Sierra Peak. We got about 2.5 miles to go. I don't know if you guys can see that, but those radio towers up there is where we're heading. So we're gonna be just traveling along this fire road still all the way to the top. Right now I came from all the way down here, past, you can barely see the trail right down there, and down off the 91 freeway.
It's a beautiful day out here right now, so let's go get it.
Come for you. Tell me what you wanna do, what you gonna do.
pretty wild. I just had a look like a police helicopter circle me just to kind of see what I was doing. That's never really happened to me before. Kind of fun. Got super low, did some sharp turns. You just never know what's gonna happen out here, you guys. It's just, that's the exciting part, is you just be walking down a trail and you see or hear a helicopter coming straight at you. Then all of a sudden it's circling you. And you're like, do I put my hands up? Do I freeze? Do I just keep going? What's going on? Am I supposed to be here? Am I not supposed to be here? Did I miss a sign? It was a little exhilarating. You know, sometimes good things happen out here. Sometimes bad things happen out here. You just don't know what you're gonna walk into. All right, you guys, I made it to the top of Sierra Peak, and boy, it is showing out today. I'm super stoked right now because I have one of the best views I've seen in a long time. I'm surrounded by just all these mountains and hills in this valley between the Cleveland National Forest. We have San Jacinto way out there. We have a lake right in front of us right here. I always forget what the name of that lake is called. If you guys know, leave a comment below. Then we got the big San G and those 11 peaks. Look at all that snow on San Gorgonio, San Bernardino. And then we're gonna shoot all the way across here. We have a beautiful view of the Three Sisters. And then way over there, Mount Wilson, we have the ocean. Catalina all on this side. This is a super rad peak. Didn't really expect such a great view, but we are in the center of all these mountains and we're at the north end of the Cleveland National Forest, and it's just a super cool view, you guys. We got Chino Hills State Park. It looks like a desert wasteland right here. I am at about 7.5 miles. I'm gonna enjoy a snack right now. I'm pretty hungry, and then we're gonna make our way back down another 7.5 miles back to the truck. I highly recommend this trail, you guys. It's beautiful. Some clouds are kind of moving in, so yeah, let's get going. at another trail right now. I could do like a loop if I take this way, but I have zero beta on it right now, so I'm a little bit skeptical. It's called Telephone Trail, and it looks like I would be taking that all the way back down right to the 91. It seems like it would be a shortcut for me. I'm pretty sure I'm gonna take it right now, but it's just kind of sketch because I don't have a lot of beta and it turns into like some kind of road. I'm gonna see if I could find anything on it right now. I do have service. Yeah, I do have it. It's the Pipeline Trail. I'm gonna go ahead and switch over to that. I hate admitting this, but it's gonna take about a mile off my. I don't mind that. It's on the front face. It's gonna have a beautiful view the whole way down. I think it's kind of worth it to kind of see a different part of the mountain as well. So as much as I feel like I'm being a little bit of a weenie for cutting a mile off, I think I'm making up for it with the views. So we're gonna do that now. It looks a little sketch from all the rain. Let's check it out, you guys. All right, so I just came from that trailhead from the top of Sierra Peak. I'm heading down that Pipeline Trail. It might even be more of a workout than the original 15-mile trail that I had planned, only because a lot of loss and gain in elevation. But check out these. This is a lot steeper than the other trail. I'm super pumped I didn't come up this way. I wanna point something out. I don't know if you guys can see it, but there's like a rock formation right west of the Prado Dam. It's like a ridge line. And one of my goals is to traverse that ridge line. Very east tip of the Chino Hills State Park. So I just gotta kinda like figure out a way to get to that, but I'm going to for sure. So stay tuned for that in some future episodes here. This trail is super steep. It's a killer on my hamstrings. Took me about 6 hours, but I made it back to the truck. I like that trail. I would probably give it a 4 out of 5. It was a little boring, but the view at the top definitely makes it worth it. I was just right up there, came all the way down. You can't even see the peak from here, but it was pretty epic day. Thanks for watching, everybody. If you like this video, please hit the thumbs up button. If you want to see more hiking and cooking outdoors, please subscribe to my channel. I'll see you guys next time.